All right, in this one, we're going to learn about complex numbers in C and how there is a handy syntax to it since the C99 standard. So you can see that's what I'm using to compile the program here. And so let's jump right into examples. So I have a CFMT function. All it does is it takes in the complex numbers and puts it into a string. Don't worry about how it works. It's just to show the examples, how they work. So what you do to declare a complex number, you just say your real type, so float, double, long double, anything that is supported by your compiler. Then you say complex, and then just the name of your variable. So let's say z is equal to 2 plus 3 times I. And notice that the I is uppercase, and that's also a macro that is defined in complex.h. And that's how you declare the imaginary part of a complex number. Let's just quickly print it. So z, cfmt z, like so. And as you can see, we have what we expect, 2 plus 3i. Next, you can have some basic operations on it. For example, if I want to print the r, like the real part of z, I can use c real function on z. If I want the imaginary part of the complex number I just declared, I can use c image. And as you can see, you get 2 and 3. You can also do basic arithmetic operations on complex numbers. So if I copy that lower and I say z2, and then I say like something else, like 4 and 9, then I print, let's say, z plus z2. And here I just do z plus z2. And yeah, it's quite handy. You just use the regular plus like any other number. So that works well together. You can also do times, for example. Let's see that it works. So yeah, here it added 2 plus 4 and it added 3 plus 9. That's how you do complex number addition. And same here, it did like, I think, the binomial distribution between the components of the complex numbers. My complex numbers are knowledge is a bit rusty, but yeah, it's about what you expect. You can also have of course all the math function you're used to, so absolute, sinus, cosinus, exponential, stuff like this. You have all of those in the complex.h header. So let's just print a new line for separation. Then let's say, for example, c apps of z is equal to something f. And then you can just do c apps of z. And all the math functions are just the regular math functions, but prefixed with a c. So yeah, that's it. Let's do sinus, for example. And let's do, cosinus for good measure. And yeah, of course, this returns a complex number. And so here it's a string. And yeah. As you can see, the absolute value is 3.6, which is what you would get if you did 2 times 2 plus 3 times 3, and you take the square root of that. You also have the basic behavior of imaginary numbers. I just quickly tried this earlier to prove to myself that it made sense. What I mean is, if you see FMT, the imaginary constants, you get I, of course, but then if you square it, so I times I, and you do 3 and 4, and here it's like times I, times I, times I, you get the basic pattern that you learn in your complex numbers class, where one I is of course one I squared is minus one, then I exponent 3 is minus I, and then I exponent 4 is 1, and exponent 5 would be back to 1i. So, and it loops like this. So yeah, that's just a quick example. I should also mention that, as I said, you can use floats here. You can use floats here. But if you use floats, it's here it works, maybe, because like floats are compatible with double, but it would be better to use the f suffix in all your function, like so. And if you use the long double up, you have to use the l prefix to all of your function. Again, it's very similar to the whatever, that's a float thing, but it's very similar to the math.h header conventions. Of course, if you don't want to worry about that, I made a video a while ago about type generics macros, and one place where it's implemented in the standard library is the TG math header. And so that's type, TG is a type generic math. And so that means that you can just use sinus, cosinus, and those would actually be macros. And so you could drop the C prefix, and you could drop all the like H, F, L suffix at the end, and just use the regular function, and it would automatically adapt to your type. So let's maybe try this. So if I include TG math like so, and you can see, it's just sinus is the same, cosinus is the same. So yeah, that's quite handy if you are like doing a lot of numbers operation on quite a different number of types. You can just have a less naming convention fluff around your thing. And that's basically all I wanted to say about complex numbers. I hope this video made them a bit clearer, and that showed you that there is actually quite a nice syntax, even though we're in C. That's it. See you in the next one.